Important topic of ER module is extended ER diagram features. So this question always been asked in each and every examination, maybe specialization, generalization, in some examination maybe aggregation, or in some examination explain all the extended ER diagram, explain all the extended ER diagram features. So all three can be asked in the examination for 10 marks. If you are asked only for 5 marks, they may be asked, right? So what do you mean by this specialization? To understand specialization, we'll consider this diagram. Specialization is the process of dividing the main entity into sub entities depending upon the differences among them. It is the process of dividing the main entity into the sub entity by focusing on the differences among them. So if you see, the person is main entity, it is divided into employee and the customer, right? Then employees are further divided into officer, tailor, secretary. So it means that this process goes from top to bottom. It goes from top to bottom by focusing on the differences in the lower level entity sets. So that whenever you divide the entity set into further entity sets, you must focus on the difference between them. Definitely employee of the bank and the customer of the bank, they are two different entities, right? Employees get salaries, whereas customers get credit rating, or you can say they get interest on their accounts, right? Employees, different types of employees, officer, tailor, secretary, and so on. If you take the example of engineering as the superset of all the engineering, below that we can have, say, consider this is the engineering main branch. Below that you can have different types of engineering: computer, IT, EXTC, civil engineering, mechanical engineering, and so on. And you know that definitely there is a difference between electronics engineer and the computer engineer. So we are, whenever we divide the main entity into sub entities by focusing on the differences, this process is known as specialization. So you must stress on the point that you are always focusing on the differences in the lower level entity sets when you divide the main entity, and this process is called as specialization. Then the next question comes: how do you represent specialization in ER diagram? Always remember, it is represented by the symbol triangle like this, labeled by ISA. ISA is labeled by ISA. When you read the diagram, you should always read it from bottom to top. Employee is a person, customer is a person, like this. Okay. Specialization is always represented by triangle labeled by ISA in ER diagram. So three important points you should write in the examination if this question comes. Specialization is the process of, first point, very important point is, specialization is the process of dividing main entity into the sub entities by focusing on the differences among them. Second important point is, it is represented by a triangle labeled by ISA. And this process, third point is, this process goes from top to bottom. Then there is another concept called as generalization. To understand generalization, again, I am going to use the same diagram. Generalization is the process which is exactly opposite of specialization. This process, generalization process, goes from bottom to top, exactly reverse. It goes from bottom to top. Now, how do you define a generalization? Generalization is the process of gathering or collecting common features in the lower level entity sets to form higher level entity sets. So in this particular diagram, which are the common features among the lower level entity sets? It is person ID, name, street, city. These are the attributes which are common to all below entity sets. So we collected all these attributes and we put it into the higher level entity set, that is person, and we formed it here. This process is known as generalization, which is exactly opposite of specialization. Again, it is represented by a triangle ISA. And how are you going to read it? Again, while reading, you have to go from bottom to top. So you can say officer is an employee, teller is an employee, secretary is also an employee, and so on. This is very, very important. we have seen that we can relate two entity sets via a relationship set like this. So employee relates with branch via works on relationship. Similarly, job relates with branch via again works on relationship. We have other relationships, that is managers. Employee manages job, employee manages branch. Similarly, we have one more entity set here, say manager. Manager manages employees, manager manages branch, manager manages jobs. So there are many relationships that may happen in between two entity sets. So here we have works on and we have manages. Consider a ternary relationship works on here in above diagram, above part of this diagram, which we have already studied in the previous slide. Suppose we want to record now the managers for the task to be performed by each employee at the branch. If manager wants to record the task to be performed by each employee at the branch, then I must relate managers and work. I must relate these two diamonds, but I cannot join two diamonds because there is no possibility of finding the relationship between two relationships. We cannot relate or join two relationship set. Okay, relationship set works on and manages represent overlapping information. If you see above diagram, they are representing overlapping information. Like employee works on branch, employee manages branch. Similarly, manager manages employees, manager manages job. So there are definitely overlapping information happening in this relationship set. It means that there is a duplication. We need to avoid that duplication. Every manager's relationship corresponds to works on relationship in above diagram. However, some works on relationship may not correspond to any manager's relationships. So we can't discard the works on relationship from the above diagram. Now, to eliminate that particular redundancy, what is there in the above diagram, to eliminate the redundancy that is happening here in this diagram, we have to apply now three steps. Treat the relationship as an abstract entity. It means this particular works on relationship can be considered as abstract entity set. So because of the aggregation concept, it is possible to treat a relationship set as an abstract entity set. Then second important point is allows relationship between relationship. So aggregation is the concept which allows you to show the relationship between relationship sets. Allows relationship between a relationship. Then the third point is abstraction of relationship into new entity. Now we'll see, if I apply these three steps, the new diagram will look like this. So we removed the unwanted lines here from the above diagrams. One which goes from managers to the job, managers to the branch, managers to the employee. So we are treating now, we have made a big box here, having everything inside it. Ternary relationship, that is between employee, job, branch. There is a ternary relationship called as works on. Now we are considering this big rectangular box as works on table or works on entity set. So now we can read it like manager manages work. You can consider this particular rectangular box as a work entity set. Everything is managed by the single manager. So manager manages this entire thing, job, employees, branch. And we can consider this rectangular box as a now new entity set, that is work. And this is possible because of aggregation. We are able to show the relationship between relationship set. So we are able to now show the relationship between managers and works on. So we read it, this particular diagram as manager manages work. This in the final exam, what should be the answer for this aggregation? You have to draw this particular diagram having ternary relationship, and there are overlapping relationship between two relationship sets. There are definitely overlapping relationship between two relationship sets. We can't join these two diamonds by a line. That is a rule of a ER diagram. You can't join two diamonds, right? We cannot show the relationship between relationship set. Then to show that, you write these three lines. To eliminate the redundancy that that is happening in between above diagram, you have to write these three lines. To eliminate the redundancy via aggregation, we treat relationship as an abstract entity, allow the relationship between relationships and abstraction of relationship into a new entity. So these three lines are very, very important that you have to write. Then the solution of it. That was the problem. This was the problem. And the solution for this is this particular diagram. So you are removing all the unwanted lines from the ER diagram, and you are making all the ternary relationship entities into one big entity set. That is, you can name it here. You can write here for this big rectangular box as a work relation, work entity set. And manager manages work is the relationship now in between the work and manager relationship set.